Good evening. What's your name?
My name is Samuel J. Comroe. I'm a stand-up comedian.
Oh, wow. How long have you been doing that?
I've been doing comedy for 10 years now.
Do you do it full-time?
Yeah, do it full-time.
Okay. Are you nervous?
No, I have Tourette's syndrome, so I twitch a lot. I blink real fast. My head flops around. If you see that, it's kind of cute.
It is.
Thank you.
And what does this mean to you, coming to AGT now?
This means everything. I've worked my entire life for a moment like this. They don't come very often. I'm really grateful. I just had a baby girl. And this is a beautiful opportunity.
Wow. And your family's all supportive of this career?
Yes, since I started, they've been 100% behind me, so I'm very thankful.
All right. Well, you know what? It's scary enough doing whatever you do to hit that X, and I just want the best for you.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
Go ahead.
Thank you. So like I said, I have Tourette's syndrome. It's why my head flops around. I blink real fast. It's weird. It always looks like I'm trying to tell you a secret. This twitch gets me in trouble. My roommate came home from work. I was like, dude, our neighbor died. He said, did you kill him? I was like, nah. Yo, this is a true story. When I was 10 years old, my parents sent me to Tourette's camp. Yeah, that's where the joke should end. It's a real place, and I didn't realize it till this moment, but I found out that when other people twitch, it makes me twitch more. So on the first day, they put us in a circle with 100 kids.
Oh, no.
The kid next to me did a shoulder roll. And my Tourette saw that and took that as a challenge. And I threw him a head flop. The girl next to him did a full body twitch, and everybody saw that, and all hell broke loose.
That is funny.
Kids were rolling on the ground. I was in the corner like, why'd they send us here? Our parents were on top of a hill like, oh, they're breakdancing. I'm Samuel J. Comroe. Thank you.
Just tell the audience, for those that didn't see the last episode, you have...
Swagger.
Just we want to say something first of all. Don't be too good though tonight, because that's not great.
You can be too good, just not too amazing.
Yeah, just that's don't be, just don't be too good.
Okay.
So I'm married. I've been with her for 13 years, high school sweethearts. And the year before we got married, she put a time frame on me to propose to her. She was like, "Hey Sam, come here. You have 3 months to propose to me, or we are through." All I could think is, if you're gonna put 3 months on me to show you how much I love you, after we've been together for so long, I'm gonna make this the worst 3 months of your life. You brought this trickery upon yourself. The next week, we went out to dinner, I got down on one knee, she was like, oh my God, this is it. I was like, nah, girl, I gotta tie my shoes. They loose. She been nagging me recently, she wants me to get a new car, I'm not gonna do it. I drive a crappy car, I do it on purpose. With a nice car, it's impossible. You gotta be polite, let people cut you off, because you don't want to mess up your car. With a crappy car, I go to the hell I want, I run these streets. Last week, a dude cut me off. I'm not gonna let him get away with it without him seeing me glare into his soul to let him know what he just did to me. I drove next to him, I flipped him off, he flipped me off, I cut him off, he cut me off. We end up in a parking lot, he got into his car, I got into my car. He was like, yo, homie, I'll key your car. I was like, yo, homie, I'll key my own car. Yo, this dude wanted to fight me. I was like, bring it, I'm not scared of anybody. I was bullied when I was younger. You're not gonna bully me as an adult, okay? And here's the thing, if you fight me, you are at a disadvantage. Because if you beat me up, you're a dude that beat up a dude with a disability. And if I beat you up, you just got your ass kicked by a dude with a disability. I'm Samuel Comro. Thank you. What up? Yo, I've been working for this moment for over 10 years, and I gotta tell you, it's a dream come true to follow two dolphins doing whatever it is they were doing. That's why I do this. My wife and I, we just got a puppy recently, got it from the shelter. Lady at the shelter told me that she was a German Shepherd puppy. I was like, dope. I got a police dog. I've had her for 6 years. She's still this big. Which means either that lady lied to me or my dog has Benjamin Button's disease. She's slowly turning into a pug, which are the worst, they're the ugliest. Some of you look like you have one. I'm sorry, they're not cute. They don't have noses, they look like they smoke. Pugs look like they smoke a pack a day. They look stressed. I got a dog, so when stressful things happen in the real world, I know when I go home and open my door, my dog's gonna be right there like, hey. And I'm gonna be like, hey. You can't do that with a pug. You walk in, you're like, hey. Your pug's like, where you been? I love my dog. I just walk around the block all day. That's my life. And I was walking her a few weeks ago, and this dude in a truck pulled up next to me, slammed on his brakes. He was like, hey, you with the dog, what kind of dog is that? And I was like, I don't know. She was supposed to be a German Shepherd. I've never seen anything like that. And she said, oh, and I said, why? And he said, because I have one. And then he reached in his passenger seat, and he pulled up a dog that looked exactly like my dog. And I had a moment where time froze, and I thought I was gonna look down and just be holding a leash. I was like, damn, you drive-by magician with your puppy magic. When I got her, though, she was really sick. This is no joke, 100% true. She was really sick. I took her to the vet, $3,000. The vet was like, you have a 30-day period. You could take her back, switch her out for a new one. I was like, yo, I'm not renting a movie. I love her. And I paid the money, and I bring it up because I'm from Los Angeles. I grew up here, but I've seen it all over the country. A lot of homeless people, and every homeless person I've seen always has a dog. And as a little kid, I was always like, where are all these homeless people finding all these dogs? And now that I got a dog, my theory has completely changed. I don't think you're a homeless person and you just find a dog. I think what happens is you go to the shelter, you try to do something nice, you adopt a dog, that dog gets sick. You invest your hard-earned money into that dog's health. You become homeless. And then you keep that dog because you deserve it. I'm Samuel J. Comro. Thank you. Yo, what up? Yo, people keep asking me how I'm the only one in my family out of 7 kids who has Tourette's. I don't know. But I have a theory that we were born in a very particular order. It's my oldest sister, and then 2 years later, my next sister, and then 2 years later, my brother, and then 2 years later, my sister, 5 years later, me, 2 years later, my sister, 2 years later, my sister. Yo, you left me inside too long. I overcooked. I feel like I'm performing for two different crowds right now. This is Def Jam, this is church. You guys need to pick it up. Yo. Everyone here is like, we love comedy. You guys are like, we're gonna pray for him. We're gonna pray the Tourette's right out of him. A lady tried to do that after a show. She came up to me. She was like, I could pray your Tourette's away. I was like, please don't touch me. She said, I could do it. Prayer works. I said, no, it doesn't. She said, yes, it does. I said, no, it does not. She said, yes, it does. Why would you even say something like that? I said, because 15 seconds ago, I prayed for you to walk away. And then she walked away, and I was like, oh, damn, prayer worked. It just takes a minute. That's why I can't go outside. Bad things happen. I was at a party recently, primarily black party. Cops came through. They opened the door. They saw me in the back. They got worried because I was wearing this probably. I look like an H&M mannequin. The cops came straight to me. They were like, son, are you okay? I was like, I'm fine. These guys are my friends. He said, no, for real. Are you okay? I was like, yeah, these guys are my friends. He said, blink twice if you're in danger. I was like, oh, shoot. Nope, we in danger. My black friend was in the back. He panicked. He lost it. He was like, run, he's got Tourette's. He's going to blink. We all going to jail. I'm Samuel J. Conroe. Thank you. Yeah, what up? What up, people? Yeah. Yo, I met my wife in high school theater class. We hated each other. So the teacher put us in a group, because that's what teachers do. And we had to do a skit where she played a cop and I played a robber. It was real quick. She was just supposed to go, put your hands up, and I put my hands up. Then she yelled, freeze, and I tried my best to freeze. And she didn't know I had Tourette's, so she got pissed off. I never seen my wife so mad in my damn life. I was walking off stage, she grabbed me by the collar, put my hands behind my back, threw me against the wall and said, I said, freeze, fool. I was like, damn, I'm gonna marry this woman. I like her passion. We're a silly couple, that's what makes us work. I don't like couples that take themselves too seriously. I was walking and there was this dude with his arm around his girl and he was squeezing her butt. And he made eye contact with me and he decided in that moment to squeeze hard. And then he went like this to me, as if to let me know, hey man, I squeeze butts. And I didn't like that because it was like he was telling me that I don't squeeze butts. And I wanted to embarrass him and make him feel uncool in the moment. So when he went, I just pretended to get shot. He was like, I said, no, damn it. And then this dumbass checked his hand. Like he forgot he loaded it. He came up to me afterwards. He was like, oh, you that funny guy. You that comedian with Tourette's, huh? I don't even believe you have Tourette's. I haven't heard you cuss once. I was like, that's not how Tourette's works, bruh. Only 10% of people have that kind. Most people have what I have to a different extreme. So when I cuss you out, it's from the heart. It's because I hate you. Because I don't like rude people, man. I really don't. Like, if you honk at me on the street from now on, I'm going to follow you home. People don't believe me. This is my job. I don't do anything from 6 a.m. till 8 p.m. I have a lot of time to follow you home. I don't like rude people. I get offended in public when someone's being rude. I get offended for everybody, even if I don't know you. So from now on, from this day forth, and I mean this from the bottom of my heart, if I open a door for you and you don't say thank you, I'm pulling you the hell back in. You can stay inside till you get some manners. I don't like rude people, man. A lady came up to me recently. She was like, how do you go to the bathroom with Tourette's? I was like, what the heck? That's a rude question. First of all, you don't have to add with Tourette's at the end of a question. He's always there, okay? And I've been to the bathroom and been like, Tourette's, you stay outside. I'm gonna do this. I'll pick you up after. Second reason is crazy is because you've seen my Twitch. It's out there, it's noticeable, but it's not insane. My body's not here and I'm headbutting the judges. It's not crazy. So I don't know what this girl saw in her imagination, but I've never once in my 30 years of living walked into a public restroom and just been like, everybody move! I have Tourette's, it's about to get messy. Thank you guys, thank you.